In part two of our lesson on powers and roots of complex numbers, you will learn how to evaluate a power using a coterminal angle and DeMoivre's theorem. First, let's do a little bit of review here with this example where you have to find an angle in the interval 0 to 2 pi, coterminal with 149 pi, over 6. Now, if we do this division, 6 into 149, we know that 6 goes into 14 twice. 2 times 6 is 12. We subtract 29. We know that 6 goes into 29. 4 times. 4 times 6 is 24, and we subtract to get 5. So what that division tells us is that 149 pi over 6 is equal to 24 whole pis plus 5 over 6 pi, so 5 pi over 6. Now, as we look at our coordinate plane, we know that 0 is here, pi is over here, 2 pi is here, 3 pi is here, and so on. We know that this is going to be all the even pi's, and we know over here is going to be all the odd multiples of pi. So that means that 24 pi is going to be coterminal with 0. So certainly 24 pi is even. So 24 pi would be here on the positive x-axis. And then we have to go 5 pi over 6 more. So starting from here on the positive x-axis, we have to go 5 pi over 6 more. And we know that means we will end up over here. And this angle, of course, starting with 0 and going 5 pi over 6 more, means we are going to end up at 5 pi over 6. So the coterminal angle is 5 pi over 6. And 5 pi over 6 is coterminal with 149 pi over 6. In this example, we have to evaluate the quantity negative root 3 over 2 minus 1/2 I to the 46th power using DeMoivre's theorem. Use radian angles in your trig form, then put your final answer in rectangular form. The first order of business is to draw our complex number z and put it into trig form. Z is equal to negative radical 3 over 2 minus 1/2 I. So if we draw that, our x value is negative radical 3 over 2, and our y value is negative 1/2. There's z. We have to find r and theta. r is going to equal the square root of x squared plus y squared. So that will be the square root of negative radical 3 over 2 squared plus negative 1/2 squared, which equals the square root of 3/4 plus 1/4. We know that 3/4 plus 1/4 would be 4/4, so this becomes the square root of 1, and we know that the square root of 1 is 1. Now the tangent of theta has to equal y divided by x, which is equal to negative 1/2 divided by negative radical 3 over 2. This 2 and this 2 will cancel. Negative over negative becomes positive. We have 1 over radical 3, which we can rationalize. So the tangent of theta has to be radical 3 over 3. Looking at our special angle chart, the tangent row to the value of radical 3 over 3, we go up to discover that theta r is going to equal pi over 6. Now because we are in quadrant 3, we know that means that theta is going to be 7 pi over 6. So we have now that in trig form, z is going to equal 1 cis 7 pi over 6. Our next step then is to use DeMoivre's theorem. Which we know says that z to the n is equal to r to the n cis n theta. We were being asked to find negative root 3 over 2 minus 1/2 I to the 46th power. That means we're taking z to the 46, which we know means we're doing r to the 46th cis 46 theta. So that's going to be 1 to the 46th cis 46 times 7 pi over 6. Well, happily, 1 to the 46th is very easy to do. We get 1, and then cis. Well, let's do some canceling here. We see that 46 and 6 have a common factor of 2. So the 46 will become 23, and the 6 will become a 3. 23 times 7 is going to be 161 pi over 3. Now, we need to find the coterminal angle between 0 and 2 pi that's equivalent to 161 pi over 3. And we just reviewed how to do that. So let's take a look here. If we divide 3 into 161, we know 3 goes into 16, 5 times. 5 times 3 is 15. Subtract, we get a 1. Pull down the 1. 3 goes into 11 3 times. 3 times 3 is 9. And when we subtract, we have a remainder of 2. So this means that 161 pi divided by 3 is equal to 53 whole pi's plus 2/3 of a pi, so 2 pi over 3. Now if we draw a quick sketch, we know that 53 is an odd number. We know that all the even multiples are going to be coterminal with 0. So we know this is 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, etc. Over here, we know this is pi, 3 pi, all the odd pi's. Since 53 is odd, that means that 53 pi is going to land over here, coterminal with pi. So we have to start here, and then we have to go over by 2 pi over 3 more. And we will end up here. So if we start at pi and we go 2 pi over 3 more, well, that's 3 pi over 3 plus 2 pi over 3 is 5 pi over 3. So this is the coterminal angle. Let's come back now to our equation. This will equal 1 cis 5 pi over 3. And of course, this is the trig form. We have to put our final answer in rectangular form. So this becomes 1 times the cosine of 5 pi over 3 plus I times the sine of 5 pi over 3. We know that at 5 pi over 3, we can use this same diagram over here. Our reference angle is pi over 3. We are going to get 1 times the cosine of 5 pi over 3. We know that the value has to be 1/2, and we are in quadrant 4 where cosine is positive, so 1/2 plus I times the sine of 5 pi over 3. We go back to our special angle chart. The value is radical 3 over 2, and in quadrant 4 it's going to be negative. We're multiplying by 1 on the outside, so this becomes 1/2 minus radical 3 over 2 I, and this is our rectangular form.